Hopefully one's ethnicity does not impact or influence their ability or their need to participate in a clinical trial. The way it should be perceived is that patient populations that may not necessarily have equal access to care do on clinical trials. Everybody is randomized in the same fashion and has an equal chance of receiving the drugs that are being tried. People's perceptions of clinical trials are oftentimes culturally based, and sometimes it is really hard to get past the generations of mistrust in the medical community based upon either cultural experiences or family experiences. That is one barrier that is there and is very difficult to cross, but it doesn't mean that it can't be crossed nor that it shouldn't be crossed. It just may take more time to get through that barrier. But it's a very real one, and it probably does significantly impact the lack of minority enrollment in clinical trials. And that being said, many of the misgivings that people have happened so long ago that they actually don't even know the details. And so it's almost whispering down the lane. So now you're trying to overcome a barrier that's only partially understood. I always try to explain to my patients the importance for minorities to participate in clinical trials so that we're represented in data analysis. We don't all metabolize drugs the same way. And I think it's important for people to recognize within their patient population based upon genetics what the potential benefit may be, as well as the potential toxicities. If you are a slow metabolizer or a quick metabolizer, that information is only gained by participating in clinical trials and having the data analyzed.